don't be afraid to look around you and see what's interesting. That's kind of how I got into science. I looked at a rock and it was just such a difference between what I saw in my hand with just my eyes and what I saw under the microscope. My name is Emily Chin. I'm a geologist. My specialty is in igneous and metamorphic petrology. As a geologist, I study rocks, and I'm interested in the lithosphere, which is the outer rigid shell of our planet, made up of rocks and tectonic plates. The lithosphere can be 100 kilometers thick beneath the continents, inaccessible. So one of the things that I'm interested in is looking at xenoliths, which are rock fragments brought up in volcanic eruptions that actually sample this inaccessible part of the lithosphere. So much of my research is focused in California, which is an active plate boundary. We have earthquakes, magmatism, volcanoes, and a really diverse history of geological events that are recorded in the rock record. We take rocks from the field, then we take slabs of them, and we polish them, and that's how we look at them under the optical microscope first, and then we take them to the electron microscope to get grain boundaries, things that are happening at the mineral scale, because we need to understand the microscale to understand how everything's working as a plate boundary or as a mountain belt. It's not just in the upper crust where earthquakes form. They actually extend all the way down to the crust mantle boundary or even deeper. And that's where these xenoliths come in to understand the rock properties, because that's really what controls earthquakes. One of the big things about Scripps is the freedom that I have here to pursue research. That's my passion, doing research. And being in an environment that fosters research first is really important to me.